Until recently, I've been pretty committed to Bushnell's TRS-25. I own several of them on everything from rifles to shotguns, and I've never regretted it. In the past couple years though, I've noticed my eyesight takes a lot longer to focus than it used to, and that's presenting a bit of a problem when engaging moving targets like swinging plates. I've owned some premium optics before, and while I certainly appreciated them, I've never really found they made enough of a difference for my purposes to justify the price tag. With that in mind, I decided to try a more affordable optic in the form of TruGlo's 1x28 Triton. A fairly compact optic, the Triton mounts directly to a Picatinny rail and takes up just a bit more space than the Bushnell did. Like the TRS-25, this sight is windage and elevation adjustable, however, that's where the similarities end. The Triton features a large lens, three different colors of illumination, and removable sunshade. More importantly, the Triton also has four different reticle options that can be cycled through via a switch mounted on the rear. That right there was my main attraction to this optic, as the circle dot reticle is significantly larger than the Bushnell's dot, allowing me to acquire it much faster. As far as build quality goes, it's decent, if not quite as impressive as the Bushnell. The body's made of a nice, lightweight aluminum and feels well put together. The lens is large, clear, and includes an anti-reflective coating, which works well in conjunction with the removable sunshade. The brightness and controls feel tight and secure, with easy to discern clicks when adjusting the windage and elevation. With the construction covered, let's talk a bit more about the actual optic. The Triton has four different reticle styles, including a small and large dot at 2.5 and 5 MOA respectively, as well as a small and large circle dot with outer diameters of 20 and 45 MOA. Powered by a single CR2032, the variable illumination provides three intensities for each color. Unfortunately, the manufacturer doesn't list battery life. However, based on past experiences with similar optics, I'd estimate it's probably somewhere around 300 hours or more. It's not easy to film, but each reticle is crisp and clear. Those larger reticles have also made a major difference in reducing the time it takes me to acquire a target, while the smallest dot allows for even finer positioning than the 3 MOA did on my Bushnell. The tricolor option, from which the Triton derives its name, is a neat feature, even if it's not something I plan to use a lot. Standard red has always been my preference, as I have problems focusing on green and blue light properly. That said, it certainly doesn't hurt to have options, particularly at sunset when the red sky can interfere with red illumination. As an added bonus, the Triton happens to sit at the perfect height for most modern rifles, allowing me to co-witness my Magpul backup iron sights without needing a riser or adapter. Although there's a lot to like about the Triton, I did still come across a couple issues I thought I'd mention. As I stated earlier, the finish on this optic really didn't impress me much. There are some small marks on it here and there, and the matte black coating just doesn't compare to other optics I've owned. It's not a big deal, especially in this price range, but I'd have been okay with paying a bit more if it meant TruGlo went a little bit further with the finish. The second thing that annoys me about this sight is the battery cover, or more specifically, the threading on it. The fine threading is very, very narrow, and you really have to make sure the cap is lined up when tightening to avoid cross-threading it. Unfortunately, that's been my experience with a lot of budget and mid-ranged optics, but it's still disappointing. So far, I'm really enjoying the Triton overall. I've cycled it between several different firearms, including shotguns and rifles, but eventually settled on the M4 I originally purchased it for. It's maintained zero flawlessly out to 100 yards on everything I tested, right up to a 12-gauge shotgun, so I'm confident that it'll meet my demands without any trouble.